I was very lucky. My very first audition in New York, I got into a Broadway show. I've been dancing and singing since I was 6 years old, and it takes a lot of hard work and dedication. It's not necessarily true that talented people get a job, but if you work hard and you have the love and drive in your heart, you can make anything happen. We hope that you enjoy 42nd Street. Domo arigato.
ミュージカルコメディー 42nd Street は1980年ブロードウェイのウィンターガーデン劇場で初演の幕が開きました。それ以来ニューヨークとロンドンで公演が続けられています。 42nd Street のプロデューサーデビッド・メリックは、私のモットーは肩が凝らずリラックスして楽しめる完璧なミュージカルを作ることであると言っています。ストーリーは単純でとても分かりやすいものです。コーラスガールの一人がちょっとしたハプニングが元で一夜にしてスターになるという夢物語です。時代は1930年、アメリカの大都会ニューヨークとフィラデルフィアが舞台です。新作ミュージカルプリティレディの話を聞き、たくさんのコーラスガールがオーディションを受けにやってきました。主人公のペギー・ソーヤーもペンシルバニアの田舎からオーディションを受けに来たのですが、どうやら遅刻をしてしまったようです。
Julian Marsh is doing a show.
It's Variety. Julian Marsh is doing a show. Job! We're gonna work again. Get out your tap shoes. Francis,
Julian Marsh is doing a show.
First audition, 10 a.m. tomorrow.
Well, Miss Jones, what do you think?
Not a bad bunch, Andy. Gladys, you're improving. Winnie, keep those knees up. Boys, you gotta pick them up and lay them down. They're paying $4.40 a seat out there. Mac, get all the names and addresses. I want everything set to go when Julian Marsh gets here. Come on, Bert. We still have 4 songs to write.
We got the whole weekend. Well, let's have those names and addresses.
She gets a little behind in her ring.
Oh. Well, look who's here. You remember Ann Riley?
Anytime, Annie. Who could forget her?
She only said no once, and then she didn't hear the
mother not having any children.
All of you! This is still an audition, dammit. And if there's anybody here that doesn't want this job, the nearest bread line is around the corner. That's it, Mac. Get those names and addresses.
All right, let's have them. Move up! Looking for somebody?
The dance director. I'm here to get into the show.
Well, you're a little late. They've already picked the chorus. You should have been here at 10.
Oh, I was. But it took me an hour to get up enough courage to go through the stage door. You're not Mr. Marsh, are you?
Billy Lawler, one of Broadway's better juveniles. Say, I'll bet you're new to show business.
Oh, I've had experience.
Oh, how many shows?
Any number of
such
them.
Such as?
Well, this would have been my first if they'd taken.
I'd take you any day. Say, how about lunch?
Oh, no, I've got to see the dance director.
Okay, then dinner, or maybe lunch
That's
tomorrow.
That's very kind of you, but I really...
I know a bundle of humanity. She's about so high, I'm nearly driven to insanity. When she passes by, she's a sunny little honey, but also hard to kiss. I'll try to overcome her vanity, and then I'll tell her this. I'm young and healthy, and you've got charms. It would really be a sin not to have you in my arms. I'm young and healthy, and so are you. When the moon is in the sky, tell me, what am I to do? If I could hate you, I'd keep away. But that ain't my nature. I'm for vitamin A. Say, I've got an idea. You're not going to get Annie Lee to audition you now unless he's got no choice. Come with me.
Come on.
You do know this song, don't you?
Oh, well, yes.
Okay, kid, go to it.
To what?
Your first notes on Broadway. What are you looking for?
My good luck, sir. I wore it when I was elected Miss Allentown and Miss Junior Elk.
Come on, kid, sing. I'm young and healthy.
Healthy.
And you've got charms.
It would really be a sin
not to have you in my arms. I'm young and healthy, and so are you.
When the moon is in the sky, tell me, what am I to do? If
I keep away, but that ain't my nature. I'm full of vitamin A, say.
I'm young and healthy.
Come on.
So let's be born.
In
a year, talk free, maybe we will be.
Paint it from the top, Oscar.
I'm young and healthy, and you've got charms. It would really be a sin not to have you in my arms. I'm young and healthy.
Hold it!
Andy!
Yeah?
Mr. Marsh is here. I just saw the taxi pull up.
I got no time for breaks. Marsh is here. That's great, George. Let's go.
Don't go. I'll talk to Julian myself.
I don't want to get you into any more trouble.
Yes, well, you said
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What the hell was that?
She wanted to get into the line, boss.
Ours are Notre Dame's. All right, everybody gather around. Listen to me. Today we start work on a new show. You're going to rehearse 4 weeks and try out in Atlantic City. You're going to work 12 hours a day, 7 days a week. You're going to dance until your feet fall off and you aren't able to stand up. But 5 weeks from now, Pretty Lady is going to be the best damn show this town's ever seen. You're on your way to glory and $32 a week. So anybody who doesn't think he can take it better quit right now. Nobody? Good. Then take a half hour to get measured for wigs and costumes, and let's go to work!
Peggy Sawyer, 125 Elm Street, Allentown, Pennsylvania. Look, you go on your fitting. I'll see that you get it.
Okay.
Julian, that was a great speech you made, and you won't regret a word of it. Pretty Lady is the best show we've ever written.
And now, with the greatest director on Broadway...
Never mind the soft soap, Bert. I need this show just as much as you do.
Wall Street got you, too, huh?
You know the old saying? There's a horse's ass for every light on Broadway. Well, I've given all I had to that glittering gulch out there, and it's been one hell of a ride. Okay, so the crash got me down for the count. But I'm still Julian Marsh, damn it. The Pretty Lady's gonna put me right back on top. Let's talk about the cast.
The best in town. Billy Lawler for the juvenile. Bert and me playing the character part.
And Dorothy Brock for the lead.
Brock, I'm worried about. Her last hit was 10 years ago.
We have to use her, Julian. She's got Abner Dillon in her back pocket.
No, you know, Dillon's kitty cars. Hey, he's agreed to put up the whole 100,000. If she's the star.
But she can't dance.
Put a bunch of girls around her. Let her wave her arms a lot. The public will never know the difference.
I don't know, Maggie.
Easy, Marsh. Here she comes. Dorothy! Dorothy, allow me to...
Don't say a word. I want to do this myself. Oh, Mr. Marsh. Ever since I saw my first Julian Marsh show when I was a tiny little girl, I've dreamed of the day when I might work with the king of Broadway. Oh, at last that day has come, and I am filled with pride, joy, and humility.
Thanks, Miss Brock. I'm feeling a little full myself. Now, before we go any further, I'd like to try you out in one of the numbers.
Hold on, Mr. Marsh. Dorothy don't have to try out. She's already got her contract.
Mr. Dillon, what would I do without you? And by the way, there were a few items you forgot to mention, so I wrote them in. Limousine, a redecorated dressing room, private maid. No problem about the salary. I just added another zero.
Oh, wait, no, see here,
don't we? Of course, if there are any objections, well, I won't insist. Oh, we'll just pedal our kitty cars, and you go pedal your fish.
You're not hearing me, Miss Brock. I said, I'd like to try you out on one of the songs to see if you can handle this role.
If you are asking me to audition, Mr. Marsh, I'm afraid the answer is no.
Oh, no, wait. No, it's not an audition, Dorothy. Julian just wants to find out if it's the right piece.
Why were you when we sent over yesterday, Dorothy? Oh, you are going to love it. Now, Bert and I see you in this low-down dive. A piano pounds out a hot jazz beat as you enter and sing. Shadows on the wall, I can see them fall here and there, everywhere. Silhouettes in blue, dancing in the dew. Here am I, baby, where are you? Shadows, let me come and sing to you.
Maggie.
Let me dream a dream that I can bring to you.
Maggie! Thank you so much, Maggie. That was just fine. Wonderful. Oscar, try and 3/4 time for Miss Brock and take it down the tone.
Oh, Julian, I'm sorry, Miss Brock.
On the top, Miss Brock!
Shadows on the wall, I can see them fall. Here and there, everywhere, silhouettes in blue, dancing in the dew. Here am I, where are you?
That's fine. Mac, Andy, I want two shin busters, one right and one left.
Coming out now.
Miss Brock, right over here, please. Thank you. Frankie,
yes.
See if you got a scrim on 28. Bring it in.
Coming in, Mr. Bird.
Oscar, top of the chorus, nice and easy. Kill the word lights. Miss Brock, if you please.
In the shadows, let me come and sing.
Ow! That's all right. Just face straight front.
To you, let me dream a song that I can bring. Gotcha.
And I've got you. Look behind you.
To you. Take me in your arms and let me cling shadows when I come and sing. In the shadows when I come and sing. In the shadows, in the shadows. Let me feel that I mean everything to you. Love's old song will be new. In the shadows when I come and sing to you, dear. In the shadows when I come and sing.
Not bad, Miss Brock. Not bad.
Mr. Marsh, what does it take to get a compliment out of you?
That was a compliment, Miss Brock.
Oh, Laura, where are you? Oh, how do you expect me to dance with sleeves halfway to the ground and feathers up my nose?
Hello, kid.
Pat, what are you doing here?
Had to see some booking agents in the neighborhood. Thought I'd stop by, say hello to my best girl.
But what if Mr. Dillon were here? No, Pat. It's too dangerous. Oh, now here, be a darling. And go take in a picture show or something. And I'll meet you in my dressing room at 5.
Dorothy, I can't take your money. It was all right in the old days when we had the act in vaudeville. But now you're a star.
What difference does that make if we still care for each other? Oh, Pat, don't you think I hate meeting in corners like this? But isn't it better than not meeting at all? In the winter, let me bring the spring to you. Let me feel that I mean everything.
Dorothy,
goodbye, my darling.
Come on, girls, get a move on. We only have an hour for lunch. this hat.
Oh, thank you, Miss...
Jones. Maggie Jones. Hey, you look like you could use some grub. How about putting on the feed bag with me and the girls? Not another word. It's all settled.
Hey, kid! I've been looking for you. How about having lunch?
I'm sorry, but I just promised to eat with Miss Jones and the girls.
Would you like to join us?
No, thanks. I'm looking for a mouthful, not an earful. But don't feel bad. I'll let you have a rain check.
What makes tenors such wolves? I think it's that tight underwear they wear.
No, that's what makes them tenors. Now, come on, girl. I'm going to take you to that lovely place with all the windows.
The afterroom!
The automat.
Oh.
Oh, all right. The gypsy tea kettle. But you're going to have to dance your way over. I don't want to waste any time.
I don't know your steps.
Well, if you think you can pick it up, I'll show it to you.
Okay. Okay.
Now with the pullback!
You're good.
I know.
Come on. Let's put it all together. Come on, two, three, four. No, thanks. There's enough on the tablecloth. Now bring us five combination dinners. And get the lead out. We're heavy tippers. Well, Peggy, you still want to get into show business after today.
Oh, more than ever. Imagine someday dancing on the same stage as Dorothy Brock. I understand how she feels. My grandmother felt the same way.
I don't know how you can say that. Dorothy has worked very hard to get where she is. I remember on her first show, she made 30 bucks a week and sent 100 home to her mother.
Let's face it, the only thing she has over anyone at this table is Abner Dillon.
Who's he?
Her sugar daddy. Oh, her father.
You can't be just 21. A girl can't get that dumb in just 21 years.
Kid, we're gonna have to teach you the Broadway facts of life.
Oh, don't worry about me. I learned all about men in Allentown.
Eugene O'Neill would have given his eye teeth to have written that line.
Should we tell her about musicians?
All she has to know is that they keep them in a pit, and it's for a good reason.
Well, I still wish I were in the show with you.
Oh, you will be, kid. Oh, if not this show, the next one. You're a looker. You can chirp like a bird. Pretty hot stuff in the steps department, too. Oh, you hoofers are the luckiest ones in this whole darn business. So what if you had a bit of bad luck this AM? You've got all you need to cheer you up. Right there at the end of your ankle. If you've a melancholy case of the blues, I've got a remedy for you. If you've an ounce of rhythm down in your shoes, then I'll change your point of view. If you've been singing a sad and blue song,
don't give up.
hell do you think you're doing? Here I am knocking my brains out, trying to put on a show they'll pay good money to see, and you're giving it away free on the street. You kids, get back in there. This is great, just great.
Nothing wrong, boss?
Wrong? I'm shy, one girl. That's what's wrong.
Boss, you told me to pick two dozen.
Why, one for good measure. I always pick one for good measure.
I never heard you say that.
Don't give me any excuses. Get me another girl.
Maybe I could have one here first thing in the morning.
That's just ducky. I can hardly wait. And I'm supposed to set the boardwalk number this afternoon. You know, I got a good mind to pick out the first girl I see on the street.
That's it.
Just walk up to the first dame who passes and say, hey, you.
Who, me?
Yeah. Can you dance?
I'm from Allentown, Pennsylvania, and I can do any type step I've ever invented. Whees! Tramples! Blows! Shuffles!
Allentown, take it easy. You got the job.
Dad!
Andy!
Yeah, boss?
Take her in there, get her ready to rehearse at 2 o'clock sharp.
2 o'clock sharp, this way.
Wait a minute! Aren't you the Mack truck that tried to run me down this morning?
I'm sorry, I didn't know it was you. It'll never happen again. I swear, my mother or my father, man,
all right, all right, all right. Well, you just relax, kid. I kind of enjoyed it. Now you get in there and start learning those routines. We got a show to do.
Thank you, Mr.
Hey. It is morning. The sun sparkles brightly on a section of the boardwalk in Atlantic City as we discover Rodney and Madeline. Madeline speaks.
Darling, darling, why did you take so long to declare yourself? The answer is yes, of course. We'll live together in a cottage by the sea, and every morning we'll have breakfast and kisses in bed. Oh, my God.
And Rodney says...
And will you always love me, Madeline?
Yes. Yes.
And Rodney declares his love, and they kiss.
Hold on a minute! What's that feller doing to Dorothy?
Oh, I'm just acting, Mr. Dillon.
Oh, don't care what you call it. I ain't putting up good money to see the lady I love kissed by no actor.
All right, cut the kiss. Just say the speech and improvise something.
Oh, my darling, I love you. I worship you. I adore you.
I don't know exactly how it started, but it started in fun. I just wanted someone to be gay with, to play with someone. But now I realize that I could never let you go, and I've come to tell you so. Something that I could take or leave alone. But now I couldn't do without my supply. I need you for my own. Oh, I can't break the way I must have you every day, as regularly as coffee or tea. You've got me in your clutches, and I can't get free. You're getting to be a habit with me. Thank you.
Her name is Peggy Sawyer. She's new.
Are you okay, kid?
She's fainted!
Thank God!
It's not Peggy's fault, Julian. She didn't get any lunch.
All right, Mag, Billy, put her in Brock's dressing room. The rest of you, this is still a rehearsal. Andy,
yeah, boss.
I want to clean up the last section before the pivot.
Right after the last section before the pivot.
Watch it. Be careful, Mac. Okay, easy. Set her down.
What happened?
One of the kids fainted. Par for the course in a Julian Marsh show. Hey, get us some water, will you, please? And you better get back out there before the boss starts yelling for you.
Well, when she comes in, tell her I'll be back as soon as I get a breaker. The name is Lawler.
Billy, Lawler!
Come on, Billy.
Are you all right?
Oh, I guess I fainted.
Good guess.
But I guess I'm all right now, because I'm...
Bad guess. Now you let me be the doctor for a while. What you need is a little rest.
Oh, but rehearsal isn't over
yet.
Oh,
yes, it is, little lady. For you, anyway. Now, as your doctor, my first prescription is for you to sit on that chaise.
Please.
And as your doctor, my second prescription is for you to get those legs up.
And I'll bet I know what your third prescription is.
Dorothy, I didn't expect you
until... It's quite obvious you didn't expect me, Doctor.
Darling, she fainted. They brought her in here until she came to.
And since when is my dressing room an emergency ward for every clumsy Corrine who throws a little fainting act? Now get her out of here, or I'll prescribe a little medication she won't like so much.
Jesus,
you shut up! And if my prescription upsets you, Doctor... You can just get out with her.
What the hell is going on in here? I'm trying to conduct a rehearsal on that stage.
Who are you?
My name is Pat Denning, Mr. Marsh. I was the guest of Miss Brock.
Oh, yeah? Well, beat it. Miss Brock's official gentleman friend happens to be in the house. And I don't want him to get any funny ideas.
Oh, Abner. Oh, Pat, quick, behind the shed.
Stay where you are. Come in, Mr. Dillon. We were just having a little script conference.
Hello, Sugar Plum. I just brought these posies for you. Hope I wasn't interrupting anything.
No, not at all. No, we were just winding up. Yeah. By the way, this is one of our dancers, Miss Peggy Sawyer. And her boyfriend, Pat Denny.
Now, just a moment.
Say, Mr. Dillon, did you realize it was your fault that this conference is breaking up?
Our fault?
That's right. Dorothy said she didn't want to discuss the script any further because she wanted to be alone with you.
Do you mean that, Dorothy?
Well, of course I mean it. What girl wouldn't want to be alone with you? Just look at yourself. Come on.
Mr. Denny, your presence in this dressing room has caused a great deal of unnecessary turmoil. I suggest that such visits do not occur again. Mr. Denny, this kid's a pretty good hoofer. I don't want to lose her for the price of a bowl of chili. Take her out and get her something to eat. Miss Brock, may I please have a word with you?
Of course, Julian. Is it about the character I'm playing?
No, it's about the character you're playing around with. Now, I don't know what went on in that dressing room. But pretty lady means far too much to me to let some gigolo stand in its way. I want you to give him up.
Aren't you a little confused, Julian? You are the director of my show, not my personal life.
When your personal life gets in the way of my show, I direct that too.
Mr. Marsh, I shall see whom I please, when I please, and no show is going to stand in my way.
I think we've got ourselves a little problem. But I think I have myself a little solution. Nick Murphy, please.
Murphy? He's a killer. Julian, if you don't like the song, just say so.
No. I put a girlfriend of his in my last show. He owes me a favor. Nick? Julian Marsh? Well, I'm calling about a bit of a problem we're having. There's this fella been hanging around our rehearsals by the name of Pat Denning. I thought that since your place is right across the street, maybe you could send a couple of your boys over to persuade him to make himself scarce for the next few weeks. Right. Thank you, Nick.
It's a pleasure doing business with you. That, I believe, is the end of that.
Julian,
yes.
I just got a call from Atlantic City. They've canceled our booking, but everything's going to be all right. We picked up a week at the Art Street Theater in Philadelphia.
Wait a minute. All our shows have opened in Atlantic City.
Maybe Philly will change your luck, huh?
Maybe you're right.
Come on, let's get packing. I'm grabbing my hat and coat.
I'm leaving the captain note. Quick, call me a
ferry
boat, getting out of town.
Sorry, I couldn't take any place fancier, but you know, the old purse strings are a bit frayed at the moment.
You know a guy named Pat Denning?
Yeah.
We got a message for him. He better lay off this rock, Dave, or it's going to be too bad for him. Get it?
Yeah, I'll tell him.
Yes, well, this is so you don't forget.
Friend, with good advice. Hey, you would be your company?
Yeah.
I'd like to leave a message for Miss Dorothy Brock. Tell her that Pat Denning has joined the stock company in Philadelphia. We'll be gone at least 6 months with no forwarding address.
I'm shining my traveling shoe. Big scoop in the Daily News. Who's saying is toodaloo? Get out of town.
But I don't want to go to Philadelphia. My contract says I must play out of town in Atlantic City.
Got a note for you, Miss Brock. Fella left it last night.
But Dorothy, why don't you want to go to Philadelphia?
Says I don't want to go to Philadelphia. I want to go to Philadelphia. My contract says I must play out of town in Philadelphia.
Here's my line of going. My line here shouting.
You got everything. Hats, coats, trunks, dogs, cats, canaries. Get them on board. That dress rehearsal in Philly starts at 8 o'clock sharp. Let's get moving.
My neighbors are awful nice. They promise to be the price. They are saying of me to write it.
Company got you all to Philadelphia, so it's up to you to see that we get out of here alive. There are 25 musicians in that pit just dying to go in overtime. So let's get this dress rehearsal started. Oh, one more thing. Not all of the scenery and the costumes have arrived yet. We'll be adding things as we go along, so don't let it throw you. Professor, we're late. Let's go!
First note. What is it? What? What? Mac! Mac! Please! Thank you. I know. Who writes the words and music for all the girly shows? No one cares and no one knows who is the handsome hero. Some villain always frames, but who cares if there's a plot or not when they've got a lot of days?
see those beautiful days. You spend your dough for bouquets that grow for all the cute and cunning, young and beautiful days. Days are temporary blades. Do you think you'll recall their names? Do you but their caresses and home addresses linger in your memory of those beautiful, in your memory, see those beautiful, in your memory, all those beautiful
Congratulations, kids. That was damn good.
Too damn good. I am the star of this show, Julian, and I do not appreciate making my entrance 10 seconds before the blackout.
Are you suggesting that I bring you on after the blackout?
I am suggesting that you redo the dance to suit my talents.
That might make it a rather short number, Miss Brock.
You are going to regret that remark, Mr. Marsh. You may be the director of this show, but I'm driving the kiddie car.
All right, the rest of you. Now you've earned it, so I want you to go out and relax. Forget all about Pretty Lady until tomorrow. But then I want you to come back here and give the performance of your lives. Company dismissed.
Company dismissed.
Company dismissed.
Thank you very much. Everybody, half hour, 8 o'clock tomorrow. Patty, that goes for you, 8 o'clock, half hour.
Willard,
check those spot cues.
I'll finish changing, Peggy. Meet you at the stage door.
I'll be there in a minute, Billy. Are you coming to the party, Mr. Marsh? To the Regency Club. Miss Jones and Mr. Barry just invited everyone. Is something funny?
Yeah. You are. Eyes shining like a kid at Christmas, dreaming of parties and opening nights. The tinsel and glitter of musical comedy. Just look at yourself. A speck of dust on this stage. Indistinguishable from the 40 other specks of dust that I put there.
I know that, Mr. Marsh. But put all those specks together, you have something alive and beautiful. They can just reach out to 1,000 people we've never seen before.
Broadway dreams, Sawyer. We've all had them.
Well, I mean to hold on to mine, Mr. Marsh.
So did I. Sweet dreams, kid.
They are. I'm a speck of dust in your show.
Matt, are you sure there were no calls for me?
No, Mr. Rock.
I need another drink. Oh, play something gay, will you? Something not from the show.
Say, another one of these, and they'll build a bridge over you.
Another crack like that, they'll build a monument over you.
Yep, I've turned around until you've disappeared. How does that feel, sweetie?
Like a dead wet cobra.
North.
Hey, what's eating you tonight?
I finally figured out what the show needs. A few more songs by Irving Berlin. Now get away from me, and then take Buffalo Bill with you.
Now wait a minute. I got $100,000 in this show, so you better not give me the air.
Oh, I better not give you the air.
Yeah.
Well, how about a few bubbles?
Oh.
Now get on your kitty car and pedal back to Tulsa, you beached whale.
Oh, she didn't mean it. She's all excited. You know the opening tomorrow?
There ain't gonna be no opening tomorrow. Not for Dorothy Rock. She's out of the show.
Wrong. Rock opens tomorrow night as scheduled. Don't be a fool, Dillard. You want to toss away all that money because of a dame?
It's my funeral, ain't it?
And the funeral of a 50 kids who danced their feet off to give you a show you could be proud of. You want to put them out in the street, too?
Oh, Mr. Dillon, you wouldn't do that, would you?
Not after we put all of our faith in you.
But she called me a whale and a goat.
Listen, in show business, that's a compliment. What you need is some fun. Why don't you come to a quiet corner, and I'll sing you the scores of my last 6 shows.
I don't care how many hotels you've tried. Try the Belvedere, too, and now.
I don't know what got into her. She was fine this afternoon.
Bert, I smell a rat. The rat's initials are Pat Denny.
Hello, Belvedere. Do you have a Pat Denny there?
You do.
Oh. Well, give him to me, you idiot.
Force. Yeah. Hey, Force.
Yes. Whoa, it's a switchboard. She's an old pal of mine. She just told me Dorothy Brock's been calling all over town to get Pat Denning. You see, I was right. Denning's in town.
Pat? Oh, Pat, darling. I can't go on like this. I've tried to forget you, but I just can't. So please, come back at once. At once.
Say, Peggy, how about the next dance?
In a minute, Billy.
What are you going to do about Denning, boss?
Call Nick Murphy. I think he's got a couple of Philadelphia cousins who might be able to handle this situation.
I can't take it anymore. I just can't.
Dorothy, calm down and tell me what's wrong.
And you should first hold me. Hold me and never let me go.
It's all set. Two of the boys began tenders. And they better not find Denning here.
Hey, how about that dance now?
I'm sorry, Billy, but I'm afraid of finding in trouble.
A man's friend or a lady friend?
A man's
friend. I get it.
Good night, Peggy.
Billy,
something the matter, Billy? Not anymore. Come on, let's have some fun.
Who is it?
I just saw you, Miss Brown.
Peggy Sawyer. Oh, the fainting violet Mr. Denning took out to dinner last week.
I get to see. Oh, Pat, there's going to be trouble.
You're darn right there is, unless you get the hell out of here.
Now, wait a minute, Dorothy. What is it, Peggy?
Two men, friends of Myrtle.
Don't you tell me to wait a minute.
But how come you're sticking up for her in the first place?
Now, Dorothy, you don't understand.
I think I understand all too well.
No, you don't.
But get out of here. Both of you.
Well, Miss Brown.
It's all right, Peggy. Now, Dorothy.
I said both of you.
All right, if that's the way you want it.
That's the way I want it. Now, get out. Out! I know now I'm the lonely one. I had to learn how a heart can yearn, how tears can burn with no one to turn to. I know that I can't forget. I can't, for I don't know how. I guess I never knew how I needed you. But sweetheart, I know now. I can't forget it. I can't, for I don't know how. I guess I never knew how I needed you. But sweetheart, I know.
Thank you.
should. Great. But this is the number that counts. You send them out for the intermission, buzzing. That's the ballgame.
And we have nothing to worry about. The finale is the best number in the act.
Well, there won't be any finale unless Brock gets out here. Dorothy, where the hell are you?
No need to shout, Julian. I can hear you.
All right, you're on in about 10 seconds.
I have never missed a cue in my life. When I do, you can take me to task. Not before.
Excuse me, Miss Brock. I just want to explain about last night.
I don't want an explanation from you.
But, Miss Brock...
Get away from me. The farther, the better.
Quiet. You're on.
All right, everybody. Cue 68. Go!
Show. You're fired. Back it up. May I have your attention, please? Miss Dorothy Brock has had an accident and will not be able to continue with this evening's performance of Pretty Lady. Ladies and gentlemen, your tickets will be refunded at the box office. House lights!
ミュージカルをプロデューサーのデビッド・メリックは日本の公演でも1930年代のブロードウェイを再現するために30トンに及ぶ舞台装置、2万個の電球、400個の照明器具、さらに500着の衣装、150個のカツラなどを運び込みました。舞台裏にはたくさんの衣装を直す人や洗濯機、乾燥機、また出演者の身だしなみを保つために美容室まで持ち込んでいます。
The show is closing!
I'm out of the show!
No,
relax. You don't have to pay an income tax.
You don't have to just pretend it's your vacation. Shut the lamp or raise your rent. Stop your nose and pinch your tent. Every situation has a shining star. Sing tra-la-la-la-la-la-la. The sun may never ever shine, but tra-la-la-la-la-la-la. The world will never find.
With no fun and no stock in your little safety deposit box,
you can never be affected by inflation.
When your car is
someone in the company with that much talent. Don't you think I would have noticed her?
Maybe not, Miss Kate.
Oh, we're wasting our time.
All you have to do is give her a chance. Isn't anything better than closing the show?
Who is she?
Peggy Sawyer.
That kid?
Yes, Peggy. She's got a voice that'll panic 'em, and she can dance rings around Brock.
She's a raw beginner. It's her first job in the chorus.
Now, wait, boss. She's the best dancer in the line.
That is not carrying a show. Brock is such an easy performer, she fooled you. That sort of style takes years of experience to develop.
Unless this kid's got it naturally, which she just might have.
Do you know how many pages she'd have to learn? Not to mention the songs and the dance routines?
She's young. Kids can do anything.
Boss, we can put the dancing back in the show.
Julian, it's worth a try, isn't it?
All right, Sandra. If anyone hits you, just fire her.
No, but it may not be too late to get her back. She's taking the 1110 to Allentown. That gives you 20 minutes to get down to Broad Street Station.
What do we do, boss?
Get her off that train. I want Sawyer in New York ready to work at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Ain't we gonna stay here in Philadelphia?
God, and lose $10,000 a night? No. The only chance we've got is to ship the show back to New York. Beat the part into her in 36 hours. And open cold on Thursday. Well, you do it. Wait a minute. This is my job. I fired her. It's up to me to get her back.
Julian, I can go.
I said I'll go. Thank you, Annie. You may have done me quite a favor.
Anytime, Mr. Marsh. Anytime. All right. We'll give him 15 minutes to convince her. Then we bring on the big gun.
Thank you.
Sawyer. You're angry at me, and I can't blame you. It's not easy being quiet.
You did me a favor, Mr. Marsh. It might not have been easy, but I got the message loud and clear. Go back to where you came from, Miss Peggy Sawyer. And that's just what I'm gonna do.
Miss Sawyer, I'm here to apologize for what happened and to ask you to come back.
I have a train to
take over Dorothy Brock's role in Pretty Lady. Her ankle's broken. She's out of the show. If you can do it, the part's yours.
I'm sorry, Mr. Marsh. Show business isn't for me. I'm going back to Allentown.
What was that word you just said? Allentown? I'm offering you a chance to star in the biggest musical Broadway scene in 20 years, and you say, Allentown? Now you listen, Sawyer, and you listen good. Even if you don't give a damn for me, think about all those kids you'll be throwing out of work if you don't do this. Think of all the songs that'll wither and die if you don't get up there and sing them. Think of the scenery that'll never be seen, the costumes never worn, the orchestrations never heard. Think of Pretty Lady and the thrill and the pleasure it could give to millions. Think of musical comedy, the most glorious words in the English language. Sawyer, think of Broadway, damn it. Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway, the hip hooray and ballyhoo, the lullaby of Broadway, the rumble of a subway train, the rattle of the taxis, the daffodils who entertain at Angelo's and Maxie's. When a Broadway baby says goodnight, it's early in the morning. Manhattan babies don't sleep tight until the dawn. Good night, baby. Good night. Milkman's on his way. Sleep.
Thank you.
Sire! You're 2 minutes late.
I'm sorry, Mr. Marsh. I was looking for my good luck scarf.
Saw your pretty lady opens on this stage in exactly 36 hours. You've got 25 pages, 6 songs, and 10 dance routines to learn by 8:30 tomorrow night. Do you think you can do it?
Well, I...
Do you think you can do it, Sawyer?
Yes, Mr. Marsh, I can.
Then we begin. Now, Oscar, where the hell's the piano? Andy, let's go!
I'm right here, boy.
Now, I'm going to start with the opening number, work through all the songs and dances, and come back and do the scenes.
All right.
There'll be a 5-minute break every hour for food or coffee, a full 15 minutes every 4 hours for a rest.
Got
no one else on the stage until I call them.
All right, clear the stage!
By tomorrow night, we'll either have a live leading lady or a dead chorus girl. What are you waiting for? Let's go!
All right, big slaps on the right foot.
And
in! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Come on! She went too wide, Andy. She's late.
All right, boss. I'll fix it.
Fix it now.
I'm sorry.
Don't worry about it.
From the ballot safe, please.
Sure. Come on, girl. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Boom.
All right. Now, we're in. Close the window.
Give
the rest of them a break. I
want to
do the love scene.
All right.
Please, Mr. Marsh. I'm exhausted. Can't we stop for a minute?
Sawyer, it is 6:30. That curtain goes up in exactly 2 hours. It's now or never. Now take it from Jim's entrance. What are you waiting for? From Jim's entrance.
Jim, they didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
No. That's impossible. Look, you're greeting the man you love. Make it mean something like this. Jim, they didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come. Now try it again.
Jim, they didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
Oh, no, that's impossible. Look, have you ever been in love? Have you ever had a man take you in his arms and crush you to him and kiss you? Say the line.
Jim, they didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
Again.
Jim, and they didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
Once more.
Jim, darling, they didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
All right, that's it. Come on,
everybody.
Marsh.
You pushed her too far.
I had to. That curtain goes up in exactly 45 minutes. If she doesn't know the part, down in her gut, she'll never get through it. And that goes for the rest of you, too. Andy,
now, boss.
Down in the lounge, clean up the last 16 bars.
Come on, Candy, down the
just called half hour. Do you think this is the time for this?
I've got some things to say to Miss Sawyer.
You're going to take my place.
I'm sorry. I know how tough it must be.
Do you? I'm not sure. When I started for the theater this afternoon, I wanted to tear your heart out. I wanted to hate you. I wanted to see you fail. You singing my songs, wearing my costumes, playing my role. But sitting in that theater and watching you rehearse, I found I couldn't hate you. Because you're good. Maybe even better than I would have been. The public wants youth, freshness, beauty. And Peggy, that's what you got. Only I'm getting something too. Oh. But 10 years the theater has kept me away from the only thing I ever really wanted. And it was a broken ankle that finally made me realize it. Pat, Denny, and I were married this morning.
Oh, Miss Brooke!
I have only one last wish for you, my dear.
You get out there and be
so swell, you'll make me hate you. Oh, one other thing, Sawyer. Now, I hope you won't mind. But it's about that next to closing number. You've got to take it easy. Let the audience come to you. Would you let me show you what I mean?
I would appreciate it very much. Dorothy.
Life begins when somebody dies. Look into your own. Life begins. From morning until twilight, I don't know I'm alive, but I know love begins at 8:45. The stars are gonna twinkle and shine this evening about a for him on needles and pins, and then the world is gonna be mine this evening about a quarter to nine. I know I won't be late, 'cause it has past eight. I'm gonna hurry there. I'll be waiting where the lane begins, waiting for him on needles and pins, and then the world is gonna be mine this evening about a
Jones or Barry or any of those stuffed shirts out there. But for us, the kids in the line,
You're not just Peggy Sawyer tonight. You're every girl who's ever kicked up her heels in the chorus. Get out there in front, kid, and show them what we can do.
Oh, Annie Gladys Lollyfill, I'll do my best, I promise.
Your best? That's not good enough. I want better than your best. I want sheer, unadulterated brilliance. Well, you kids hanging around for getting your places for the opening. Peggy, I want to talk to you.
Julian, it's 8:40. We got to call places.
They've waited this long. They can wait another minute. Now listen. And listen hard. 100 people. 100 jobs. $100,000. 5 weeks of grind and blood and sweat. And it all depends on what you do out there tonight. Now, I know what you're thinking. Here comes Marsh with another one of his pep talks. Well, this is the last of them, sort of. And it comes straight from the heart. Our hopes, our futures, our lives are in your hands. So go out there and make them shine with your golden talent. This afternoon, that was acting. This one I mean.
Julian, we've got to begin.
All right, don't you take the house to have. Sawyer, you're going out there a youngster. But you gotta come back a star.
So if you your wise rules, so to trousseau. One for getting wed, of course. And the second trousseau you sew, you can wear for your divorce. First you serve them with the peelers, then you take them to the cleaners. Then it's so long, Joe. Give the bum the shuffle
when you're back from Buffalo.
Where the Andor
looking too big for the East. You're going to be there, aren't you, Peggy? The whole shindig is in your honor.
Of course she is, escorted by Mr. Billy Lawler himself.
Girlie, you work swell. Anytime you want a kitty car, just say the word.
Now come along. We're giving a little party at the Ritz in your honor.
For me? I'll be along in a minute, Miss Jones.
We'll see you at the Ritz.
Oh! Oh! It's so exciting. They all love the show.
They all love you. And that goes double for me. Now, come on. We got to go to that kid's party at Lorraine.
Okay, Billy. I'm not sure I can. What about the party at the Ritz? Billy, am I really a star?
From now on and forever.
And can stars do anything they want?
Anything.
Then I want to go to the kids' party. Oh,
no.
Hey, Billy, wait a minute.
No, you haven't changed your mind.
Of course not. I'll be along in a minute. Oh, wait for me at the stage door.
Okay, but just 1 minute. You know how impatient tenors are.
What's the matter with me and all the excitement? I forgot to congratulate you. Congratulations, kid.
Thank you, Mr. Marsh. But you and I both know who was really out there on that stage tonight. Oh, I said the lines and I sang the songs and I did the steps. But you were inside of me pulling the strings. So, I congratulate you.
Quite a girl, Miss Peggy Salt. Quite a girl. And you're on your way to becoming quite a star. You've broken through, Peggy. You're the million to one shot that comes home a winner. For years to come, thousands of little chorus girls will go to auditions and say to themselves, who knows, I might come out of this another Peggy Salt. I ask only that you be the sort of star those little girls would want you to be. Shine your light over this glorious gulch they call 40 seconds. Give it your talent, your strength, your youth. Try if you can not to give it all your heart. Because it's a very loving heart. I would never want to see it broken. You run along to the Ritz and enjoy yourself.
I'm going to the kids' party.
I was right. You're quite a girl.
Good night, Mr. Marsh.
Good night, Allentown. Where is the kids' party?
At the Reams? Oh, the address is on the comb. And Mr. Marsh. It would be grand, grand, grand if you would
come and meet those dancing feet. On the avenue, I'm taking you to. 42nd Street. hear the beat of dancing feet. It's the song I love, the melody of 42nd Street. Little nifties from the 50s, innocent and sweet. Sexy ladies from the 80s who are indiscreet. They're side by side, they're glorified. Where the underworld can meet the elite. Naughty! Forty.